Well, let's stay with that particular big question. The Kenyan government has demanded an apology from international media house CNN for running an analytical segment terming Kenya as a terror hotbed ahead of President Barack Obama's visit. And as KTN's Sharon Momanyi now reports, Kenyans have also lashed out at CNN after it raised questions about the country's safety in light of past terror attacks. Take a look.
Opportunity during the president's trip to hit those soft targets.
A terror hotbed is what CNN referred to Kenya as, and this is not sitting well with Kenyans. But first, let's get the meaning of the word hotbed, shall we? Oxford Dictionary defines a hotbed as an environment promoting the growth of something, especially something unwelcome. Going with this meaning, CNN then stipulated that Kenya promotes and stimulates terrorism. And this is what saw the heated comments on the trending hashtag SomeoneTellCNN. At Chris Kirwa wrote, "Someone tells CNN that this is our version of terrorism, kindness in the midst of competition." He then posts a picture of the Kenyan athlete Jacqueline Kiplimo, who slowed down during the 2010 Zenkai Marathon to help a disabled athlete drink water. At Ruth Mutegi wrote, "Someone tells CNN we are a hotbed of heroes, a country which stood up to protect another country against terrorism despite the repercussions." At Mutonga Wambui tweeted, "Someone tells CNN that terrorism is a global threat." At Njeri Wangari wrote, "Someone tells CNN that American investors are willing to risk this hotbed of terror to get a piece of this Silicon Savannah." Dr. Nancy Booker of Multimedia University says this is all about news framing.
What CNN has done is what we refer to as media framing. And in media framing, what usually happens is that, you know, media houses take a particular slant or a particular issue and frame it in such a way that it communicates what they want, you know, that particular story to look like.
Heavy weapons. The Secret Service.
CNN argues that the Al-Shabaab are likely to try and make a point by targeting soft targets. Leaders have termed the CNN report as alarmist.
This announcement is based on lies and without verification. It demonstrates heightened irresponsibility by the media network and smacks of arrogance. Kenyans will recall that prior to 2013 general election, the same CNN broadcasted to the world carefully choreographed pictures of alleged warriors and militia training in a forest in preparation for war during and after elections. The entire world knows that the 2013 general election in Kenya was a most peaceful and celebrated event.
CNN has repeatedly reported negative stories on Kenya, earning the wrath of Kenyans, such as businessman Chris Kirubi, who tweeted, "Unless you are the one bringing terror, we are a hotbed of investment opportunities and great people." At Brian Karanja tweeted, "Someone tells CNN to get out of here."
If they are civilized enough, they should apologize.
There has been a steady uprising against Western misreporting of not just the Kenyan but the African story, and through the hashtag SomeoneTellCNN, angry Kenyans sought to tell their story as they know it. Sharon Momanyi, KTN News, Nairobi.